Hello and welcome. Today we are going to talk a little bit about this rather strange instrument known as the Altonium. This video is brought to you by the Ridge Wallet. If you're anything like me, you will have a wallet made of peeled cow that you could fit pretty much anything in. And as a consequence of that, it's almost too big to fit in your pocket. You almost need a yard cart to be able to carry it around. Well, in my continual strivance for minimalism, this thing here is what I now use as my wallet. This is a carbon fiber or carbon model wallet. You can fit up to 12 cards inside it. It stretches to fit them all. You've got a fold at the back where you can put some cash or anything else that you want to carry around easily. This thing here is all I need now to carry around, and I've been using this and it is brilliant. These wallets come with a lifetime warranty, and if you don't like what you get, then you have a 45-day money-back guarantee. You can get your own Ridge wallet with a 10% discount with free worldwide shipping and returns just by going to ridge.com/TrentH. That link will be down in the video description below. So before we dive into this version of the instrument, what I want to show you first is this, which is a fairly standard American bell front baritone. We have three front action piston valves. We have a bell that's angled forwards, as you can see, and this is a fairly standard musical instrument. There are quite a number of companies that made and make this sort of thing. This one here happens to be a Bach, but there are other brands out there. Now, whilst you may think this is simply a scaled down version of the baritone, it is actually what I call a hybrid instrument, in that it takes the characteristics of a couple of disparate instruments, mushes them together, and gives you something that's normally worse than either of the two contributing ones. So in this case, we have the obvious inspiration from that baritone that I showed you, but we also have some elements that taken themselves from the French horn. Namely, it's in the key of F, and it takes a French horn-sized mouthpiece. This wasn't the only style of these instruments that King made. There were actually four variations of them. I believe they came in versions in either F or E flat. Some of them had bells that went straight up, some of them went forward. I've seen one on eBay that has a removable bell, so you could change which direction it pointed. They also made a slightly bigger instrument in B flat called a trombonium, which was built along many of the same principles as this. It was just sort of halfway in size between this and the baritone. It was in the same key as the baritone, but just a much smaller bore. So in those few simple facts, you've pretty much heard most of what there is to know about this instrument. No other brands really decided to go and run with it. Personally, I'm not surprised, because the intonation is adventurous, shall we say. The tone isn't as desirable as other instruments that sit in that sort of alto family. And for a person of me who is sort of man bear sized, it's quite small. It's actually to the point where it's a little bit awkward to hold because of how small it is. If I was to try and put my thumb inside the thumb hook and actually play it, then it sort of cants my hand around at a really odd angle. So it's almost more convenient to put my hand out to put my thumb up here somewhere. It's not really built for people of my particular generosity of proportions. However, I thought, in lieu of actually providing you with an exciting program full of facts and information with which you can do many things, I thought I'd just give you an example of playing. Thank you very much for watching.